Thank you. So if you follow the phrase, yeah, you can see like if he's playing like really reflect the phrasing in the music or didn't. So I don't know, guys, if you actually know what I'm basically teaching, but last time on the worship, I was talking about the importance of intonation, so-called internal singing. This girl, right? Yes, and the thing is that intonation also help us to express everything, including phrasing. For you, I just wanted to tell you what is this, because you never tried that. Basically, it's how you feel the music between notes. Because everything that we create between notes. And the only way to feel distance between notes is to sing it. And to sing it with a bit of resistance. So, you don't want to sing distant notes like this, because there's no distance. But if you sing, then you can actually hear this line between them. So maybe you can try with something. Yeah. Yeah, so and you want to just like resolve those three chords. Alright, so this is what we call intonation. And basically, when you play, you internally sing the same way every single note. And this is how you control. Including the muscles of your fingers, the accuracy in your lips, the evenness in the passages. Usually students don't sing while playing. They simply think that, okay, if I press the key, I press the correct key, I got it, I got the pitch, everything is perfect. When, by the way, if you play violin, there is no key. And to feel the note, you have to feel the distance. How they, you know, like make clear tune, they're like, okay, this is C, and this is E, because they feel the distance. There's no like C, D, E, F, they feel it. And usually this intonation ear is very good developed in this Balinese girl child, but not with us. So, okay, coming back. With phrasing. So when you're going to express your idea about, for example, motif and length interval through intonation, then you can feel it. Because now we're going to talk about how to feel phrasing. What I did here is how to know the phrasing. You know it here, okay? But that's not enough to express through playing. To express through playing, you need to feel the phrasing. You feel it only through singing. So, if you're gonna sing, for example, a very simple one, let's imagine that this one, one motif, and the main interval F, G. So, if you just sing, magically. This is exactly how you express your ideas. So maybe you want to try to sing just a motif. So you understand that F, G is the main interval, right? So the rest is kind of not important, not important, not more important. Yes, here we are. So this is the concept, right? Now, when you know this, you start singing and feel it through the singing. So you start, and here we go. But I really suggest you try to sing it with glissando, and with little resistance. Maybe you can try first. Okay, try better. try this, and I think that everyone is able to do that. And so, so this is an example, and when you want to play this piece, you want to do the same, so you will have to intonate. Musical speech, there is a coded meaning, emotional meaning of every interval that, again, not everyone knows. So the intervals don't really represent the distance between notes, like second is small distance and octave is big distance, right? That's what we know. But every interval actually represents a certain state of mood, like, for example, second and seventh would represent more like tension feeling when you're asking, when you're waiting, you know, like please or when, you know, like a sigh. And the third and sixth represents a very romantic and beautiful emotion, like love, weird things. And so, and Chopin likes six very much. He always uses his nocturnes. So basically, romantic composers use it a lot. So basically, we can see that six and two and seven more tense, and three and six would be more less tense, more released, more open. Now the fourth, always energetic, very energetic, and the augmented fourth, which we will meet in this piece, it's a kind of, you know, uneasiness, it's a mysticism, something like is going on. So it's not a simple interval. Some magic is over there. So if we just take a look at them, and we can see, right away he starts with the second. Very painful, then he goes again second. Then he goes four. And after this again second. And after that, he follows with this augmented fourth. And then three. Again two. Four. Two. Four. Augmented fourth. Three. And especially here, so many seconds. Asking like when or why. Now this unison, as you can see, it's not just the same note, it also represents, it's also interval. So unison represents a more confident feeling when you when like an open statement. So, so he's more insistable here. And then again, he goes down by seconds. And he comes to it, doing the same fourth. And the same here. Four, two, augmented, this is very interesting thing. And again, you can feel it through singing. Then when you will sing, you wouldn't just sing. When you touch the key, when you play, and basically I can tell that everyone who listens to you, he can feel the music through you. You know, sometimes people play and you like You're like, okay, this is like so mechanical. I mean, I cannot get through this. I wonder what this music is about. And you feel like so suppressed with a lot of passages and just like it's loud and fast, okay. And sometimes maybe not loud, but slow and boring. And sometimes you hear someone, you listen, and you're like, oh, yeah, I can feel the music, I can feel the world of the music through this person. This person is just transparent. I can feel the composer, I can feel the music, I can feel that real. So this is happening when actually the pianist can play and can feel the music between notes. So more you feel between notes, more interesting your playing becomes. This is ultimately the goal. And this is what I try to teach everyone. So again, if you connect this musical speech with phrasing, and you can see, okay, the second goes to second to fourth to bring us to second down. And so you would emphasize the second so much. I just want to show you just an example. So you have to play.
Okay, let's go.
I'll try to sing this on a different level. So this is exactly how you need to sing while playing. And you will sing while you're singing with resistance, your finger will prepare how to play the key and you will control the way you play the key. Okay, now try to sing it again and somehow to feel the meaning. Basically there's only like two intervals. Yeah, two. Three. So second, feel this painful second. Feel this more energetic force. And again, second. Okay, let's try. Yeah, okay. So this is kind of hard because this one is big, you want to make it, right? But everything comes to this ascending painful, descending painful second. So try again. Bring more to descending second. Try to play just this one, and try to sing the same way, but without voice. Your voice is basically the sound of the piano. That's what we do, you know. People just like the professional vocalists. They train their voice to be beautiful. They eat many eggs. We don't have. We just choose better instrument to without our voice is done. So our voice is the sound of the piano. The way we intonate. It's all happening here. So try the same, you intonate absolutely the same way, and you touch the key only after you reach it with your voice. Okay, this is one thing. you press the key and then you move the wrist. You press next key, then you move the wrist. Mm-hmm. And your wrist will have the sound flow. Music between them.